I joined the Music Photography Awards as a judge because I love imagery. And in an image-saturated modern culture, it's a privilege to help cut through the noise and uplift image makers who are approaching photography with an iconographic point of view. I'm looking for images that are beautiful, daring, reality-defying, honest, and soulful. I'm drawn to images that sit at the intersection of ethnographic and fantastical. As an image maker and a creator behind and in front of the lens, I'm always trying to elicit an emotional response or create a socio-cultural inquiry. The question, who am I, is of course at the core of every piece of work, but it's also really important for me to ask, how can I create a visual representation of my innermost self? Essentially, how can I capture the inexpressible, the uncapturable? Visuals are a metaphor for interior life, and for someone of minoritized experience, it feels especially important to document myself and my mind and especially my body in all of my locales to show that I was here living and expressing in my own way. The first music images that had a real impact on me were probably Grace Jones's collaborations with Jean-Paul Goud. Iconic. The way she messed with gender and fashion and racial depictions really taught us that cultural criticism could be fun. I think storytelling in photography and music is important, but it's not always necessary to create a narrative. A listener or viewer is always going to create their own story when they consume an image or hear a song based on their own lived experiences. So sometimes it's equally as important to just be able to capture a mood or a moment and make it interesting enough to project upon. Let the consumer build their own story. Create the canvas for that. For me, collaboration and solitude are equally important. It's important to know who you are, what you like, and establish what your point of view is, and it's equally important to have those ideas challenged. It expands on your toolbox, your vocabulary, to see how others work. Collaboration is the surest way to make iconic work that wouldn't otherwise exist. I feel the same about experimentation. It's integral to all forms of art to experiment, to try to mess up. It's the only way to chart a new territory sonically and visually. I think soul is what makes a good subject in music photography, and I think soul is what makes a good music photographer. I usually start thinking about visuals as soon as I'm writing a song. Every song has a color and a mood in my mind. When it's time to direct the videos, I do a deeper dive on the visuals. I build mood boards and I shoot reference photos. So for me, I can't really have one without the other. I'm often writing the scene, the image that I see in my mind, lyrically. The advice I would give to photographers starting out when photographing artists would be to find a muse. Find one artist who loves being photographed or needs to be photographed. Someone who you can spend copious amounts of time with. I mean, really get sick of each other. And hopefully you can discover each other through photography and get a sense of what you are drawn to and inspired by visually. This person will serve as a blueprint, as a rudimentary platform upon which you can build your taste, and you can then take that taste and apply it to everything else you shoot. I wouldn't necessarily say that I work out what I want my images to say ahead of time. I'd like to think that my images tell me what they want to say. You know, they're coming through a channel, and I'm often chasing a feeling and listening to my surroundings, figuring out organically how I can tease that feeling out of the elements that exist around me. A lot of the process is improvisational. It's just taking stock of what is in my environment. I would liken it to jazz. In terms of diversity and opening doors and windows for the next generation of talent, honestly, I think that what we are in need of is a more honest portrayal of what life on Earth was like. If photography is a document of a moment in time, a moment can look different based entirely on whose lens it is seen through. And to see life in media predominantly through the lens of white creators, as it has been, just isn't accurate to the multitudes of perspectives that exist on Earth. And I think it gives us a very, very skewed image of reality. It gives us a limited view of reality. And so I think it's important to open the door to a diverse cabal of image makers, because that's the truth. There are a lot of different ways to look at one image, and I'm particularly interested in hearing what Black people have to say. Social media has definitely given me access to photographers' work that I wouldn't normally see. Scrolling through Tumblr, especially when I was younger, and discovering photographers and making inspired mood boards was an education for me in photography. These days, though, too often social media serves as a distraction. It's important to turn the devices off and go outside or go inside, further inside yourself, and make stuff. And I think that sometimes, because we have access to a platform, we get trapped by the immediacy of it and want to quickly make something and then share it. But I think it's so important to wait and to be patient, to not seek instant gratification or feedback. I didn't really start sharing my photography until, you know, almost 2 years after I'd started making images seriously. And that helped me to develop a point of view that was untethered to what would get the most likes.